Hi everyone, my name is Sagar and I'm an identity engineer with Azure Active Directory product group. In this video, we will be discussing about primary fresh tokens in Azure Active Directory and how they can become invalidated. We will also cover the steps to troubleshoot if you encounter missing primary fresh token scenario. Before we dive into the topic, let's briefly understand what primary fresh tokens are and their role in Azure Active Directory. A PRT is a security token issued by Azure AD on Windows 10 or newer, Windows Server 2016 and later versions, iOS and Android devices. It is a JSON web token specially issued to Microsoft first-party token brokers to enable single sign-on or SSO across the applications used on those devices. There are several scenarios that can cause a PRT to be invalidated, such as when a user or device is deleted or disabled in Azure AD. If a deleted or disabled user is already signed into a device, cache sign-in would lock them in. But once Cloud AP is aware of their invalid state, it blocks the subsequent logons. Similarly, if a device is deleted or disabled in Azure AD, the PRT opt-in on that device is invalidated and cannot be used to opt-in tokens for those applications. A password change also results in PRT being invalidated. The user will get a new PRT after changing their password. Sometimes a device's TPM can falter or fail, leading to inaccessibility of keys secured by the TPM. In this case, the device is incapable of getting the PRT, and any existing PRT is invalidated by Azure AD. And that's how PRT can be invalidated in different scenarios. Now let's see how to troubleshoot the missing PRT scenario. In this section, we will focus on Windows devices and some common reasons why a PRT may be missing. PRT is acquired after successful user authentication. If the authentication process fails for any reason, the PRT acquisition will also fail. This could be due to incorrect user credentials or issues with OS components or authentication broker. To resolve this, ensure that the user credentials are correct and check if there are no other errors. During device registration, the device creates an asymmetric key pair required for successful device authentication. If Azure AD is unable to validate the device signature, the PRT acquisition will fail. To resolve this, ensure that the device registration process is completed successfully and the device signature is valid. If the device is unable to reach the Azure Active Directory, the PRT acquisition will also fail. To resolve this, check the device's network connectivity and ensure that it can reach the Azure AD service. Now, let us understand how to diagnose the missing PRT issue. To diagnose this issue, log into your Windows 10 or Windows 11 device with your Azure AD credentials. Launch the command prompt in the user context. Run the command dsscmd/status. This command will provide an output that will help you locate the SSO state. You will find the status of the PRT in this output. If the Azure AD PRT is marked as yes, that means the PRT is present on the device. If the PRT is marked as no, that means the PRT is missing. To identify the errors of the missing PRT, go to the Event Viewer, look at Application and Services Logs, Microsoft, Windows, Azure AD. Highlight the operational events in AAD. Here you'll find the prominent errors that you may have received while the PRT acquisition. If you want to dig deeper and understand what happened in the background, go to analytic logs and make sure that you enable them and then reproduce the issue. And that is how you can quickly diagnose the reasons of the missing PRT. In the upcoming videos, we will talk about the detailed troubleshooting steps that you can take to resolve the missing PRT issue. Thank you.